वंदे गुरुपद्वंदम भक्तबिंदसमन्वितं श्रीचैतन्य प्रभु वंदे नित्यानंदसहोदितं श्रीनंदनंदन वंदे राधिका चरणोदयं गोपीजन समायुक्त बिंदावन मनोहर वाचाकल्पतरुवश्च कृपा सिंधु विवच पतितानं पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः मूकं करोति वाचालं पंगुं लंघयति गिरिं यत्किपातमहं वंदे परमानंदमाधवं वृंदावई तुलसीदेव वै पिया वै केशवस्य स्नभक्तिपदे देवी सत्वत्वयी नमो नमः नारायण नमस्कृत नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयो मुदीरे संकीर्तने कृष्ण कथोपदेश गौरी पत्रस्य प्रकाशने च सदानुरक्त गुरुभक्ति युक्त भक्ति प्रमोदाक्ष जगोत्पदन्य धैयं सदा परिभवग्नमभीष्टदोहं तीर्थास्पदं शिवभिरञ्जनुतं शरण्यं भीतात्यहं वनदपालभवद्विभूतं वंदे महापुरुषते चरणारविन्दं यत्पादपल्लवनखचन्दमणिच्छटाय विस्फुरजित किमपि गोपवधूषु अदर्श पूर्णानुरागर ससागर सारमूर्ति साराधिका मयि कदा श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिव सदी गौरभक्तबिंद श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिव सदी गौरभक्तबिंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे आजानुलंबित भुजौ कनकावदातु संकेतनैकपितरो कमलायताक्ष विश्वाम्बरो द्विजवरो जुगधर्मपालो वंदे जगत्प्रियकरो करुणावतारो हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे नमामि गंगे तव पाद पंकजं सुरासुरैर्वंदितो दिव्यरूपं भुक्तिं च मुक्तिं च ददासि नित्यं भावानुरूपेण सदा नरानं गंगातरंगरमणीयजटाकलापं गौरी निरंतरभिगुषी त्वां भागं नारायणो प्रियमनंगमदापहारं वरांसिप्रियपति भयवीशनाथं वागीशजिष्यो वदने लक्ष्मीर्यस्य च वक्षसि यस्यास्ति हृदये संवित् त्वं नृसिंहमहं भजे हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे मज्जन्मनः फलमिदं मधुकोटिभारे मत्पार्थनीयमदनुग्रहो एष एव tadbhritta bhitto paricharika bhitto bhitto bhrittascha bhitto iti mam smaro lokanatho majjanamano phalamidam madukaita bhari matparthaniya madanugraho yeso eva tadbhritta bhitto paricharako bhitto bhitto bhrittascha bhitto iti mam smaro lokanatho Gauriya Goshtipati, Srisila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada, Jagadguru told, really it is impossible to take a jivatma out of the trap of maya, out of the jail of maya, and to help that jivatma to reach the lotus feet of Supreme Lord, to his eternal service. Really impossible. What a great task it is. Common people, foolish, they don't understand. Gauriya Goshtipati, Srisila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada, Jagadguru told, it is really almost impossible to take a jivatma out of the jail of maya, out of the trap of maya, and to help that jivatma to reach the lotus feet of Supreme Lord. To engage that jivatma into eternal seva. What a great task it is. Foolish people, common people, they don't understand. In the name of bhajan, they are joking. Actually, point is there. We know that directly and indirectly everything done by Supreme Lord. Many times, Prabhupada used to say, what is happening, what will happen, what is happening, what will happen, what already happened, all for good. I mean, a pure devotee never find any fault with Bhagavan, never find any fault with Guru Vaishnava. This is the main symptom of a bonded soul. This is the main symptom of a bonded soul, that always bonded soul like to find fault with others. Bonded soul can never see own faults. That is the main problem. All the time, bonded soul always going to search fault with others. This is the usual tendency. But we like to do just opposite. We like to find Prabhupada advising. Many times Prabhupada speaking, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati, it is my request, it is my advice to you all, that you all try to find fault with yourselves. Don't try to find fault with others. You try to find faults with yourselves. It is my advice to you. Unnecessarily don't try to take control over Guru Vaishnava. Don't try to get all name, fame, honor, position like Hiranyakasipu. Don't try to make the absolute truth. Don't try to give lecture on absolute truth wrong way. Distorted form of absolute truth is not truth. Half truth is always dangerous. Half truth is always dangerous, more dangerous than total false. That's why, in the name of preaching, don't try to preach all wrong conception. Preaching means jivedaya. Perhaps for the first time you are hearing. Preaching means you sign one kind of style, one kind of very like canvasser, like a medical representative. Why you are coming in my field? Foolish number one, idiot. Why you are coming in my field? You are medical representative, eh? That's why he's speaking. Try to understand, preaching is nothing but jivedaya. Try to understand and memorize, digest. So many things you are hearing, I know. But you will have to detect which is absolute truth. Otherwise you can die without any spiritual treasure. You'll have to go vacant. Your hand is vacant. without any power, without any treasure, paramarthic treasure, spiritual treasure, you'll have to go away. Preaching actually means Jivadaya. Try to understand. Nityananda, Haridas Thakur, they were ordered by Gauranga Mahaprabhu, go and speak about my teachings and go Harinam Mahamanto, then Bilaiya. Distribute. So preaching doesn't mean to represent himself, to project himself. Preaching means to speak all about what Guru Varga told, Gauriya Guru Varga, Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda Thakur, nothing personal. Is one kind of trick. Nothing personal you can speak. So preaching means Jivadaya. What do you mean by Jivadaya? Just now I started. You think it is a joke. You think it is a joke. You cannot understand what is Jivadaya. What is Jivadaya? If you understand, realize from heart, then you surely you cannot attack me. If you realize from heart what is Jivadaya, surely you have no scope to attack me. You are attacking because you don't know what is Jivadaya. You think you are getting kipa from different place. That kipa can put you in more danger. At present, what bondage condition is there, Prabhupada speaking, more and more dangerous position you can reach. Bonded condition you can reach. More and more, day by day. So, Jivadaya means actually, preaching means actually Jivadaya. Jivadaya means to change their heart. To change their heart, dirty culture, dirty things, dirty, you know, habit, all you have to change, and you have to help them establish in Krishna Bhakti properly, not in the name of Krishna, but something else. Totally. It's very tough. Hiranyakasipu wanted to chide Prahlad Maharaj, wanted to threat Prahlad Maharaj. But still, Prahlad Maharaj never wanted to change the truth. Prahlad Maharaj never wanted to deliver absolute truth in a distorted form. Intact, Prahlad Maharaj is speaking without any fear, fearlessly, Prahlad Maharaj. Hiranyakasipu. And you are going to change your, all Siddhanta, Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur simply for some pratishtha, little pratishtha. You can sell the sampradaya. Oh, no problem. I have to go look your own profit. This is your preaching. So preaching means actually Jivadaya. Jivadaya means just I started with the sloka already I told. Prabhupada told. It is very difficult to help a Jivatma to come out of the jail of Maya, trap of Maya, and to help that Jivatma to reach the eternal feet of Supreme Lord is called Jivadaya. Exact explanation is Jivadaya is to speak what Prabhupada told. Exact Jivadaya is that you will have to speak what Prabhupada told. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami. That is called Jivadaya. I know people cannot like me. But still you have to speak that way. It is the duty of Guru Vaishnava to show Jivadaya. And another point Prabhupada used to explain very often, that if those who are brahmachari, sannyasi, they are feeling attraction from material things, material appliances, material things, kamini, kanchan and everything. If they themselves cannot understand from heart that this world is unstable, then what preaching they can do in front of public? They can cheat. Preaching not cheating. They themselves cannot realize their life is unstable, this, that. They are not ready to accept what Prabhupada is speaking. How we can expect that they can do bhajan? Simply by applying tilak mala? Who told you? This is the question. Prabhupada speaking, those who are sannyasi brahmacharis, they themselves cannot realize that life is unstable. If they are feeling attraction for Kamini Kanchan, etc., then it is very dangerous. Very dangerous. Then they can never do bhajan. They can never enter into eternal world, eternal seva. They never can do. Directly or indirectly, everything done by Supreme Lord, it's okay. Somebody asking, we are doing some sinful activities, that is also done by Bhagavan. Somebody speaking in front of Prabhupada. Okay, you speak that everything indirectly, directly done by Bhagavan. So you mean, what do you mean? So all different sinful activities we are doing, that is also jive, that is also the mercy of Bhagavan. Just now in Hindi Katha, I was discussing the situation in which you are put into, you should think it is Bhagavad Daya. The situation in which you are put into at present, always you should see, you should think that it is the mercy of Bhagavan. So somebody is asking, you speak this way, what does it mean? If you are doing some sinful activity, this is also jiva, also the daya, mercy of Bhagavan. Prabhupada said, no, not at all. Then why? Bala Bhagavan, Bhagavan going to keep the option of doing sinful activities. Bhagavan never going to give instruction to any jiva. You can do sinful activity, never. This prachodayat, in the morning time you are doing Gayatri, that is not that Bhagavan can give inspiration to murder somebody, to go to woman association, not that. Foolish. You are thinking wrong way. Not that. Bhagavan always try to give us, those who are favorable to Bhagavan, those who are favorable to Bhagavan, Bhagavan always giving the nice inspiration. Those who are not favorable, not averse to Bhagavan, naturally they are facing Maya. So according to that formula, Maya going to control them. They are going to be controlled by Maya. So what Bhagavan can do? Bhagavan never has told them, never advised them to do sinful activities. Prabhupada speaking, no, Bhagavan never going to advise anybody to do sinful activities. It is one kind of provision kept. Like I can give one example, when in Gaur Lila we find when Nimai, very small boy, Nimai going to start first writing. Going to write first. A, B, C first. Not A, B, C. That time A, B, C was there. Of course was there. But still, Mahaprabhu writing, just like a material boy. Mahaprabhu going to this Leela. After that, there was one function. When Brahmin, Vaishnav, they are coming. They are going to put some option for the boy. Like you go through Chaitanya Bhagavat, you can find Chaitanya Bhagavat in Nimai. One book was published 12 years back, Bengali. Very nice book, in which I give everything, all photo, everything. Very nice. Actually, what is the taste of the boy? All pen, books, Bhagavad, all different kind of lucrative offer kept in front of the boy. And the boy going to catch one thing. Then all the Brahman Vaishnav, they are going to check up what is the taste of the boy. To check the taste of the boy. Then about Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, I can say it is written that so many things were there kept in front of Nimai, and Nimai don't understand anything, he's a small boy. And father speaking, mother speaking, my son, Baba, you go and take anything, what you like. Then Nimai is straightway going to catch the Bhagavatam and give embrace. Embrace Bhagavatam. Follow. Then everybody could realize who is he. You know, this way. So, Bhagavan going to keep so many things, Kamini, Kanchan, Pratishta, so many things Bhagavan going to keep in front of you, all opposite in the name of bhajan, in the name of preaching, all everything, option. Especially those who are going for preaching. Mayadevi going to kick them all the time. Yeah. If they are Guru Nishtha, Sampradaya Nishtha, they can come out successful, otherwise big problem. Otherwise, big problem. Follow. This way, Prabhupada speaking, no, not that. Bhagavan never going to advise us to do sinful activities. It is not Bhagavad Daya. Not that. Bhagavan going to keep this provision, Kamini, Kanchan, different kind of lucrative offer. And if you are going to break your usual rule, you know, and you are going to show attraction for Kamini Kanchan, this is called one kind of test by Bhagavan. Bhagavan, Supreme Lord, going to give so many options in front of us and going to test us according to test that Jivatma can do. Follow. The example I give already is what Prabhupada also speaks in the same, in front of a small boy to check the test of the boy, test, then different kind of, you know, things are kept in front of the small boy to check the test. Infinity ocean of Daya, Bhagavan. Those bonded souls, those who are suffering naturally, because they are just running opposite, that's why they are suffering. They are going to blame Bhagavan. They are going to blame Bhagavan. Bhagavan is merciless. Those who are running towards Maya, they are facing different kind of problems. And they are going to blame the Supreme Lord is merciless. So we are in trouble. They cannot calculate that they are in Maya. They are going to run just opposite direction. Illusion is always dangerous, so they are in trouble. Bhagavan is not merciless. Bhagavan is full of mercy. Whatever Bhagavan is doing, according to our nature, all good. We have no right to speak against Bhagavan. Suppose somebody running wrong way, doing all sinful activity, getting punishment, that punishment is also daya. Follow. That punishment is also daya, because Bhagavan giving instruction to Mayadevi to put that Jivatma who is doing sinful activity into jail. And in jail, what is the target of Mayadevi? Mayadevi is going to give them treatment, different kind of treatment inside jail. And treatment after treatment, what will happen? Ultimately, if they can realize that life is unstable, we should not do it, is good. If they can at all realize that what we have done is not good, is good. So it is jivadaya. Punishment also jivadaya. So they can at least can realize that life is unstable. They can try to think positive way. So, the reason for why all devotees, pure devotees, they are running all around to save pure devotees. They are always trying to save bonded soul all the time. They are trying. Bonded soul. I was discussing about this preaching. Preaching means really jivadaya. There is no provision, there is no scope that the preacher can express some envious attitude against some devotees, pure devotees. Strictly prohibited. I was speaking previous week that if there is any pure devotee we will have to go and preach. There is priest, pure devotees here. You come. Like Ramanuja Jajo, he was given strong instruction not to express this mantra Raj. One special mantra was received by him. Goshtapurno. But he is going to give instruction. Don't speak this mantra in front of it. And the mystery of this mantra, all the mystery of the mantra was explained. It is one kind of leela. Ramanujacharya immediately after getting the mantra, going in front of, you know, some devotees, in front of 70 or 80 devotees, speaking loudly this mantra and giving them diksha. Follow. Then the Gurudev was, you know, was very, very angry. A special mantra given. He is also Guru, another Guru he took. You already know. I explained before. You will have to go to hell. Why you speak this mantra? I told, I prohibited you. It is just prohibited. Why you? I prohibited you. Ramanuja speaking, well, I am ready to go to hell. If I go to hell, then if I can save thousands of people in this world, then my going to hell is nothing. I deem nothing. Oh, really? Then Gurudev could realize, oh, he's a great soul. Oh. Then you are satisfied. So Ramanuja speaking, if I am going to hell, no problem. If I can save thousands of people, they can realize what is Bhagavad Seva, what is Bhagavan. If they can enter into Vaikuntha Jagat by chanting this mantra, so no matter if I can go to hell, my going to hell I approve, no problem. I am ready to go. This is called Jivedaya. Jivedaya doesn't mean to preach in a negative way, to preach in such a way so that I can attract people towards me. And to suppress all the secrets of bhajan, Guru Varga, Parampara, glories, to suppress, to keep his secret is not Jivedaya. It is called envious attitude. It is called mercilessness. Common sense should be there. What is preaching, what is this, that. Some result must be there. Some result must be there. Now, even wrong, if you are going to do some wrong, still you can get some result. Now I can go and discuss about Sanatana Gosai, how merciful Sanatana Gosai is. Sanatana Gosai Pad could realize that it is quite impossible for bonded soul to realize what is called Shuddha Bhakti. Whereas Prabhupada also speaking, it will take thousands of births for outside people to even realize what is Shuddha Bhakti. What to speak about Raganuga, Rupanuga Bhakti. Prabhupada speaking, impossible. They are not going to allow me to speak about their absolute truth. They are very angry. Why I am speaking this way? Absolute. Now I was discussing that the Bipra was doing so nice function at the bank of Tribani, was going to distribute prasadam, everything I already discussed, I am not going to discuss. Only one point I like to clarify this point. Prasadam distributed everything. When Naraji Maharaj wanted to glorify that sadhu, that Bipra, that Bipra was feeling disgusting. Bipra was thinking, no, I am nothing. What I have done? No. Please stop. You go to South India. There is one king. His glory, you know, I cannot speak. So nice. First of all, Brahmana out of this is called humble attitude. You see, now. First of all, you try to understand the nature of a pure sadhu, like Naraji Maharaj. Naraji Maharaj wanted to expose all the pure activities of a sadhu, name and fame of a sadhu, Naraji Maharaj, through Naraji Maharaj, through Shankar Bhagavan, So many countless people, they are getting bhakti. That Brahman, out of his humble attitude is the main thing of bhajan. Guru Padma used to say many times, Dinere adhik daya karen bhavaman, kulin panditer bara abhiman. Those who are taking birth in a high family, those who are nice looking, have, you know, huge amount of lances, educational qualification, any. They are feeling proud of that, and that is their punishment. They can go to hell. Follow what I say. So Naradji Maharaj naturally going to glorify that Brahman out of his humble attitude, going to express. Thus I told already, the Guru Padmani used to say, those who are very humble, they are going to get kripa. They are not feeling excitement. They are not feeling excitement, anxiety, agony, never they are feeling. Like Hiranyakashipu is going to threat it, hey, be careful, who am I? But still Prahlad Maharaj not going to feel anxiety. So much 100% faith in Supreme Lord. Never wanted to represent absolute truth in distorted form, never. What is absolute truth? Absolute is absolute. If you leave me, if you go away, you can go, whole world can go away from me, still I can go on speaking with you because it is my seva. I am not going to satisfy you, my target is to satisfy Guru Gauranga Gandharva Guru Dharila. My target is to not to give you satisfaction so that you like and dislike and I am going to think about it. No. That Vipra going to speak, Aham Barako Ko Nu Swat, Aham Barako Ko Nu Swat, Ko Nu Swang Datum Saknomi Bakyat, Vaibhavam Vartate King Me Bhagavad Bhajanam Kuto. Aham Barako, I am useless. I am Barakaha. Ko Nu Swang Datum Saknomi. What donation I can give to Guru Vaishnava? Oh, no. And what vaibhav appliances I have? Vaibhavam vartate king. Are bhagavad bhajanam kutaha? What kind of bhajan I have done? Nothing I have done. Really so. Sanatana Goswami Pad is so merciful. You can realize after hearing step by step. Also, I was discussing about in Rai Ramananda Sagma, the gradation. Step by step. What is varnasam, varnasam, dharma, what is that? All external. Prabhupada can explain, na? Everything. Until and unless we are going to get rati, all before, all unstable, everything. That vipra are going to explain, well, you are going to glorify me? Oh my God, I don't like to hear. But one king there in South India, Kintu Dakshin Dese Yo Maharajo Virayate. I already discussed, but still I am going to remind you. Kintu Dakshina Dese Yo Maharajo Virayate. Sahi Krishna Kipa Patram Jaso Dese Sura Layaha. You can go to the kingdom of this king. You can find everywhere there is Sura Laya, Deva Mandir. Sarvatra Bhikshava. Yatro Tvaitika Bhyagata Gata Dayaho, all beggars and those who are, you know, pilgrimage, all those, you know, they are coming. They are going to get the scope to take Krishnar Pitanyam Bhunjana Bhramati Sukhinaha Sada. Krishnar Pitanyam, they are going to take rice, dal, sabji, all prasad already offered, you know, prasad means already offered to Krishna arpitanyam, which is already offered to Krishna. They are going to take this kind of prasadam, there is a facility. So they are feeling sukhi naha sada, brahmanti. They are traveling around with very blissful, you know, condition there. Now Sanatana Gosai, in his commentary, writing one very important, step by step, Sanatana Goswami Pada writing on a special point. So many things writing, but I have no scope to discuss. I am discussing under his guidance, under the guidance of Sanatana Goswami, Guru Varga. Kishnar pitatvat anyasya pavitram pavitram madhuryadi ko muhyam muhyam. Here one point, very important point. We know from Gita that patram puspam phalam toyam jome bhaktya prajachati tadaham bhakti upahitam asmami prajatatmanah. I already discussed, I am not going to touch. Main point is that whatever thing you are going to offer to Bhagavan out of your bhakti, follow, then Bhagavan is bound to take. If you are not initiated, or if you are initiated, your guru is not Sadguru, or if you know that your guru is not Sadguru, at all you are not in the line of Bhagavat Parampara, as shown by Prabhupada, not enjoying full kippah of that Bhagavad Guru, Bhagavad Parampara Guru, anyway. In that case, there is no scope that you can offer anything, anybody going to offer anything to Bhagavan, and he, Bhagavan can take, it is not prasadam. Why so many problems arising? Because they are not taking prasadam. They are enjoying. Whatever they are offering to Krishna, that is not prasadam. Whatever they are looking, they don't think it is prasadam. Ishavashramidam sarvam jatkinchit jagatam jagataha. The Upanishad, Ishapanishad going to advise, whatever thing you are going to accept in this material world, you should think it is the prasadam of Bhagavad. It is the darshan of Mahabhagavad. Whatever thing you hand over, give to them, they think it is Mahaprasadam, Ishavashamidam Sarvam Jatkinchi Jagadam Jagat. Follow, is Prasadam. Teno Taktena Vanjita Makashasiddhanam. Don't try to express your greedy mood. It's very dangerous. Follow. Kam Krodho. Bhoy, kam, krodh, lobh, moham, ascharjya, all, they are the trap of maya, through which you can be caught. So you see, Sanatana Goswami giving explanation, okay, we know, Vishwanath Chakravarti speaking, Bhagavan not going to take any information out of your love, pure love, we are going to offer anything, Bhagavan going to accept. But that doesn't mean you have no Sadguru, you have no Parampara connection, nothing. I can do. You are going to cut your Parampara connection. Here, offering. No, it is not Prasadam. It is a Maya Prasadam. It is not Prasadam. You will have to be sure that you have love for your Guru, Gurudev and Guru Parampara. You have to be sure that you have taken Diksha from a Sadguru. Our Bhagavad Parampara Guru, you are in touch, you are taking genuine Harikatha, you are hearing, you are feeling, digesting, and you are feeling some reaction, you are crying sometimes lamenting, then Bhagavan can think to accept anything from you or not. Especially Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who himself is Krishna, Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told, Those who are doing 1 lakh Harinam, Mahaprabhu already speaking, he can go through Chaitanya Bhagavat, Chaitanya Charitamrita. Those who are actually doing 1 lakh Harinam, I am going to take water and prasada, water and bhoga in their hand. Follow, Mare. Now at present, don't know judgment. Nothing there, nothing left, all gone. Even prasad distribution, outside people, with full pant, everything, okay, prasadam. Your father can know, this prasadam, foolish. Outside people, not initiated, nothing, prasadam you take. Somebody going to cook, taking salary, prasadam you think so. Not so easy, don't take it easy. All gone. All efficacy, all purity, all gone. Prasada seva korito hai sakal prapanchi jai. If Vaishnava, you know, Ekadashi Kirtan, you can go, written by Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Try to take trouble to go through Gauriya Vaishnava, you know, Darshan or Harikatha. So many I giving answer to Prasadam, everything. So many. What is Prasadam, what is not? Prasada Seva Kuritya Sakal Prapancha Jaya. Somebody going to take Prasadam, Prasadam means you can cut material bondage, but you are not cutting. That means it's not prasadam. So Sanatana Gosai wanted to clarify this point. That's why in Tika writing, Krishna Pitatvad Anyashopa Pavitram Madhurjadika Muyam. If it is not at all offered to Krishna properly, proper way, perfect way, now your main headache is to run society. Now I know your main headache is to run how to run society. It is your main headache. It is not your headache that how people can know Shuddha Bhakti. It is not your headache. Your headache is how to run this big organization. No organization, no society was formed at the time of Gauranga Mahaprabhu. Because all their heart, all devotees, they are running toward one single direction, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. But our all diversified, all our diversified inner target. Oh, you are running towards Kamini Kanchan, you are this man, woman, this, so many things. Money, position, everything. So whatever society you form, you are not going to come out successful, 100%. I am in Vyasasan. I can promise and speak. Here actually, the purity and the purity, question of purity and the question of all the glories of prasadam is there or not. You have to think it first. So in general, Sanatana Gosai says, starting from the very basic point, very basic, varnasam dharma, these, the very basic thing, after the karma, after that, gradually, Sanatana Gosai is going to enter into Golokdham, Vrindavan. There, Sanatana Gosai is going to comparative statement, going to show the Radharani or Gopikas and Radharani there, finally. Bhagavan going to speak here, Putram, Patram, Pusvam, Phalam, Tuyam, this Vakya, Vishwanath Chakravarti speaking, if out of pure devotion they are going to offer anything, then like Sudama Vipra going to give some broken rice, Krishna speaking, oh, how much satisfaction I am getting today by taking this prasadam. Follow. Bhagavan, what Bhagavan want to speak is that Bhagavan want to speak idi seka patram puja phalam tu joma bhakta prajachati. Yeah, Bhagavan want to mean what Bhagavan want to speak, that without my devotees, those who are pure devotees, with those who are not devotees, their inside, you know, their heart is not clean. Without my devotees, all other people, their heart is not pure. So those who are fully controlled, they are niskam, totally niskam bhakta, if they are going to offer patra, pushpa, patra mein leaf, flower, fruits, water, anything, immediately I am bound to take it. Bhakta prajachati, bhakti uparhitam, two times. Try to understand. First of all, patram, pushpam, phalam, tvam, joma, bhakta, prajaya, bhakta mane, out of pure devotion. Second line, tadaham, bhakti upohitam asnami. Second line, the two time, Bhagavan going to confirm, is not a matter of joke, tadaham, bhakti upohitam asnami prajadatana. With loveful mood, I am going to take. You know, Prajnaji is going to full dedication, going to give. Then I can take. Not that everybody can give and I can take. In this context, I wanted to give the example of Raghunandan Acharya. Who is Raghunandan? Raghunandan Acharya is in the line of Narahari Sarkar Thakur there, and on detailed discussion I cannot do. Raghunandan Acharya actually Katwa. There I've been there long ago, 16, 18, 20 years back, I cannot remember. I went there. There, actually one very nice, you know, things happen. The father of Raghunandan Acharya going to some place. There's a small boy and going to give instruction to the small boy that today you will have to offer this bhoga to Bhagavan. Eh? You can do, na? Very small boy. A mother going to place the bhoga plate. Mother going to place the bhoga plate on right place. And Raghunandan was instructed by his father to offer to Bhagavan. Then Raghunandan doing, he saw, he is watching what father doing daily. He is going to offer to see everything, and after that, you know, going to offer and going to point out finger. This is prasadam. This is bhoga. You take prasadam. Eh? I am going outside. Then Raghunandan going outside and waiting for the deity, I mean the Gopal, to take prasadam. After some time, Raghunandan enter the room of deity room. And watching this, the prasadam intact there, as it is, Bhagavan not eating. Then after that, the small boy become very angry. You are not taking prasadam? Every day you are taking prasadam from my father? You will have to take prasadam, a bhoga. Now, I am going outside. Follow. This way, Bhagavan was bound to take all prasadam. Like Sachimata going to offer to Nimai. Nimai, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu already there in Purushottam Nam Nilachal. Sachimata crying with the plate in the lap that my Nimai is not there. He used to take all this, you know, sabji, this, that, you like this very much. Now Nimai is not there. Who can take this prasad after offering? Nimai is not there. Heavily crying, Sachima. Immediately Chaitanya Mahaprabhu coming from Purushottam Dham in fine form and taking all prasadam from the bhoga plate. Sachimata suddenly watching the plate is vacant. Oh, maybe it is my mistake that I could not arrange bhoga or some dog or something. Who can took? No, I thought I already arranged prasadam, bhoga, but now I see vacant. Who has taken? Who knows? Oh, maybe it is impure, I will to go and wash the plate again with cow dung, everything. Again, arrange, second time, bhoga. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu already took. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking to devotees, you can go to Navadvip and ask Mataji, that day you crying heavily, that Nimai is not there, so your son, I mean, Nimai already came and took all prasadam. Took for the confirmation. For the confirmation of devotees. This is the point. So Bhagavan going to take. Our Nisinganda Brahmachari also offering. Separately Paramananda to Nisingadev and to Gauranga. And going to call, oh Prabhu, you come and take prasadam bhoga here. And Nisingadev was given separate. But suddenly Nisinganda shouting, oh my God, why you are going to take the plate of Nisinga, my Nisinga? No, no, it's separate. You take your prasad. Everybody laughing. What happened? Nisinganda watching, Gaur coming and taking all the prasad, even the plate offered to Nisinga, because he is Nisinga. Oh, and everything. So it's true, not false. All fact, actually. So you see, when father come back, then mother speaking, there is no prasadam in the plate, left. Then father asking question to Raghunandan, today what happens? There is no prasadam left in the plate. Well, what to do? You told me to allow Gopal to take Gopaladi to. Ha! What do you say? Yes. Gopaladi to go all everything. What I offer to. Gopal took? Yes. Then come. You can offer one laddu. Laddu mean one sweet ball. Laddu. One special preparation. You can offer to Gopal. Mane, father expressing doubt about this point. Then father speaking, okay, well, you go and offer to Gopal. Let me see his taking. Then after that, Raghunandan going to temple alone and going to offer the laddu, I mean sweet ball, and speaking, you take, eh? You take a laddu. My father give laddu, you take. After that, going outside, after waiting, after enter, Gopal not taking laddu. Then Raghunandan taking one stick. Raghunandan taking one stick in hand, going to beat Gopal. Eh? Morning time you took, now you are not taking, father can think I am liar. What will happen? Then Gopal taking the laddu directly from the hand of Raghunandan and started taking, half laddu taken. Father wanted to check up the fact. He wanted to open the screen and watch. Then Gopal stands still. Father could not see. Half laddu, fix up. Then even today if you go there, you can find half laddu. Half laddu there in the hand of Gopal. And now, this way. So it is not false, it's true. That Bhagavan going to take, like the case of Bidurji Maharaj, I already told you. So it is true, not false. So now Sanatan Goswami also wanted to confirm this point. Now I can go to the another, you know, sloka. It is written that Rajadhani Samipe Cha Sachidananda Vigraha Shakshad Ivaste Bhagavan Karunyam Siratan Gataha. Who's speaking? All that Bipra. Try to remember. If you miss the link, if you cannot keep link, you cannot understand. Naradji going to glorify that Bipra Brahman, and that Bipra going to point out that I am not devotee, that South Indian king is devotee. And now discussion going on. Follow what I say. Now the Brahman speaking to Naradji, Rajadhani Samipe Cha Sachidananda Vigraha Shakshad Iva Aste Bhagavan Karunyat Sthiratam Gataha. In his kingdom, you can find Sachidananda Vigraha Bhagavan. His deity, very nice deity. Out of his causeless mercy, Bhagavan himself going to take the form of deity, Sthira Marti Parugraha Purvak, as if he himself standing. Deity mean Bhagavan himself. So if bhakti is there, the deity and Bhagavan not separate. Like the case of Sakshi Gopal, Chhota Bipro, small Bipro and big Bipro, you know from Chaitanya Charitamrita. There it is a Siddhanta written, Vigraha naho tumi shakshat bhajanda nandan. You are not deity. You are Krishna himself. You are yourself. So that Brahman also going to explain from Naradji, Rajadhani samipe cha sachidananda vigraha shakshat ivasti bhagavan karunyat sthiratam gataha. He is taking the form of deity out of causeless mercy. And nityam Navanavas tatro jayate paramat savaha. And every day, every now and then, nityam mean every day, different kind of utsav festival there. Nityam Navanavas tatro jayate paramat savaha. Puya drubbani chestani notunani pratikshanam. Every, in a moment, there are new kind of efforts to satisfy Bhagavan. Pujya the brani, pujya mana items to be offered. Items, all new items, all the time. Very. And this kind of very nice effort going on to satisfy Supreme Lord. Nityam navanavos tatra yayati paramasavaha ar puja drubbani chestani notunani pratikshanam. Here, you can go and watch there, daily nityam, new festival taking place there, and all, every moment there is new arrangement of items to satisfy Supreme Lord. And that king, what happens? By Vishnor Nibeditoi Tastu Sarve Taddeshavasinaha Vaideshikasya Bahavo Bhajante Tena Sadaram. What is written? King going to offer new thing and prasadam. Vishnu Nivedito says Upacha. All new item already offered to Bhagavan. And with those item prasadam, that king going to give satisfaction to all from outside people coming, or inside country there are so many people coming to take prasadam. Bhagavan with fully king always trying his best. The king trying his best to satisfy all newcomers from outside, all those who are inside the country itself, and going to offer them prasadam nicely. Vishnor Nibeditoi Tastu Sarve Taddeshvashinaha Vaideshikascha Bahavo Bhajante Teno Sadaram. Teno mai, by the king. By the king. King going to offer them. Very. Is going to satisfy. Okay. And also it is very important that Pundarikaksha Devasya Tasya Darshana Lobataha to watch. Follow. To watch that deity, Pundarikaksha Devasya Tasya Darshana Lobataha. To take darshan of that Pundarikaksha, I mean the deity there inside his kingdom. Or after that Mahaprasad Rupad Upabhogos Sukhapti Taha. Follow. Pundarikaksha Bhagavan to see that deity and to get the chance to take prasadam there and to get sadhu sangha, it is in the next line. First line I am reading actually, number 50 sloka. Pundarikaksha Devasya Tasya Darshana Lobataha Mahaprasad Rupat Upobhogo Sukhapti Taha Sadhu Sango Tilabhacha Sadhu Sango Tilabhacha Sadhu Sango Tilabhacha Nana Deshat Samagataha Nibo Santi Sada Tatro Santo Vishnu Parayanaha. To get the darshan of that deity, okay. Also to get the chance to take Mahaprasadam also. And also to get Sadhu Sangha. Sadhu Sangha. To get good association. Vaishnava association. From different distant place. Vishnu Bhakti Parayan. Vishnu Parayanaha Janaha. Te Sarve. Gachanti. They are going there to get the association of Vaishnava, everything very good. So all these points is very important. After that, what happened? The Brahman speaking in front of Naraji Maharaj very carefully that desascha deva viprabhyo ragya datto vibhaccha sa no upadrova santi tad deshe ko opi shoko athava bhayam. Desascha deva viprabhyo, in his country those Brahman Vaishnav staying there, Ragya Raja going to distribute his land like Ramchandra. Ramchandra, Yudhishthira Maharaj, they are going to distribute all the land in the name of Brahman Vaishnav. It is yours, not mine. You are giving me seva to control, to rule, that's what I am doing. So, desascha deva viprebhyo Ragya Datto Vibhachasa. King already distributed the, you know, the land, whole land of his country in the name of Brahman Vaishnav. Okay, it is yours. I am only servant with this mood. Follow. And there is, you know, so nice place. The king is so pious. Pious, impious, this not, you know, cannot stand in the way of Krishna Bhajan purely. Now I am using. Now using. Ultimately I can show you, not use it. So the king is so pious, the countryman is so pious. There is no problem in the country. No upadrova, no upadrova asti, tat desa kopi shoko. There is, you know, no lamentation, not there, somebody not crying. And no fear of any disease, this, that, and epidemic. No fear, actually, upadrava. Shoko bhayadi dishtayana. Everybody leading their life very peacefully. Because the country is very pious, king is very pious, and the countrymen also very pious. Already that Brahman going to speak. Tad desascha deva viprebhyo ragya datto vibhajyo sa. No upadrava asti tad deshe ko opi shoko athava bhayam. Follow what I say. Very good. And it is written, akrishta pachyasa bhumi rishtas tatro mahasukham ishtani phala mulani sulabhani ambarani cha. Follow. That land is so fertile by the mercy of Mahavishnu. The land is so fertile that without cultivation, if you just distribute seed and throw seed into ground, then automatically huge amount, enormous amount of, you know, grain and fruits and flowers you can get. So nice country. The king is so pious. Akrishta pacha sa bhumir brishtis tatro yatha sukham. Rainfall is also normal. Very good. Normal rainfall is also normal. And istani phala mulani sulabhani ambarani cha. Follow, you see. All fruits and flowers, everything, you know. This way it is written, the akrishta pachyasa bhumir brishtis tatro mahasukham istani phala mulani sulabhani ambarani cha. After that is written, sva dharma krataha sarva sukhinyaha krishna tatparaha prabaha astamanu vartante maharajan yatha sutaha. All necessary items are available there, very. Eh? very all available, everything. There is no scarcity of anything. Pie, wheat, you know, barley, anything, whatever you think, fruits and flour, everything. No scarcity. And those who are living in the country, those who are staying, subject, those who are staying there, they are also very pious. They are following Dharma. And they are also in favor of Krishna Bhajan, Krishna Tatparaha. They like Krishna. They like to do something for Krishna. Sri Krishna Tatparaha Bhaliya. So naturally, they are happy. If there is no trace of Krishna Bhakti, then how happiness can come? Follow. Material happiness, unstable. Dhana jivana jauvana raja sukham nahi nita manukhyana nasaparam tejo gamma kathasakalam vipalam bhajogodruma kanuno ranjividun. Lakshmi Thakur. Follow. Dhana jivana jauvana raja sukham nahi nita manukhyana nasaparam. Anytime can unstable. So those who are living in the country, they are also happy because they have this kind of feeling. They love Krishna, they like to do something. And they are living in the country, all the countrymen, they are staying. They are like the son of the king. Father going to take care of those countrymen as his own sons. Follow, there is a pure. Sadharma kritaha sarva sukhinaha krishna tatparaha ar prabhavaha stamanu vartante maharajam yatha yatha sutaha. Follow. And that king, mani ultimate target of Sanatana Goswami Pad is to show humbleness. Gradually, Sanatana Goswami can prove that to get pure bhakti, we must be humble. Follow. If there is no humble attitude, the more we can progress, we can find one by one, ultimately can come, Shankar Bhagavan can come, Prahlad Maharaj can come, so many, Yudhishthira Maharaj can, all gradually. We can discover their humbleness. And we have no humbleness. Some preaching done, we cannot think it is done by Nityananda. We cannot think, I have done preaching, all useless. That means preaching not done. If preaching done, I mean, preaching means distribution of kripa, jivedaya. If at all you are going to show jivedaya, then why you are not going to show mercy to yourself? You are going to show mercy to others, whereas you are not going to show mercy to yourself. You are not doing justice with you. That day I was speaking, now preaching men to preach yourself, to preach in front of yourself. That day I was speaking, now preaching actually means, first of all, you will have to preach in front of yourself. If you are successful, then you can go for preaching. Or if you are half digestion, you are going to get some kippa, somehow some half digestion. You are going to preach and you are going to get name and fame, then you can think you are Hiranyakasipu. Who are you? Useless. Eh? I am all in all. Going to capture the whole field. Impossible. For the time being, you can do. Pure devotion is not such a cheap thing that you can come out successful this way. So, cha varga sada nicho. Yoggo seva bhir achyutam. I already said that the king going to take care of his countrymen like the father going to take care of sons and daughters. Follow what I say. Sacha agarvaha
means no proud mood. Saucha agarvaha means no proud mood, humble attitude all the time. Saucha agarvaha sada nicha jaggo sevabhir achyutam bhajamano akhilano lokano Ramasya Chuto Priya. Now the Brahmin going to declare that the king in South India is a dear and near, very, you know, he is a devotee of Achyuta. Who are you as glorifying me? And the king, speciality of the king is that, though he is king, what is the speciality of the king? What is the speciality of the king? The king is very famous, very nice, he is humble, and he never think anything. He never think that I am doing anything. He never think. He think Bhagavan doing everything. Achyuta Priya, you know, he is actually a dear one of Mahavishnu, Achyuta Priya, Krishna, Achyuta Priya, Nirankar without any, you know, proud, is always humble, Nirankar, no false ego, nothing, and always going to do some Nicha Janochita Seva. Nicha Janochita Seva means like Ambarish Maharaj. Savai mana Krishna padar bindayur vachansi vaikuntho varnanah, you know, karau tad mandiram arjuna disu chakara chita sat kathodai, you know, Ambarish Maharaj doing all seva himself. What seva? He is going to clean the temple. Are Maharaj, he is king, he should not do this. Yes, there are so many people, he can pay something, he can clean. No, Ambarish Maharaj going to clean the temple totally. Sing Harikatha, hearing Harikatha, all nine forts of bhakti, all nine forts of bhakti as shown by Prahlad Maharaj. Savanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu Svaranam, Pada Sevanam, Archanam, Bandhanam, Saksham, Atmani, all everything, whatever you think, nine forts of bhakti. Ambarish Maharaj going to practice himself. He is not going to hire one man to practice this, no, do seva. No, he is doing himself. It is not the seva of Ambarish Maharaj, but Ambarish Maharaj saying, no, it is my seva. Suitable seva for me. Like the case I can speak, humbleness. You know. Humbleness, try to understand. The king of Orissa, Raja Pratap Ruddho, why and how Mahaprabhu was so happy? Why and how Mahaprabhu was so happy? Can you give answer? Why Mahaprabhu was so happy? It is written in Chaitanya Charitamrita. Try to hear Harikatha from right source. If you don't like to commit suicide, you have to hear Harikatha from right source. Your like and dislike is not a big factor. It matters little. For the satisfaction of Supreme Lord, we are speaking Harikatha. We have no self-interest, no smell of self-interest. So we can speak this way. So the king of Orissa, Raja Pratap Ruddho, he was doing some cleaning job with boom, going to clean the road. When Jagannath is already there in chariot, and the chariot devotee is going to pull the chariot, not yet started the Ratha Yatra festival, and still today it is a custom, it is the rule that the king of Orissa can come, and first of all he can clean the road through which Jagannath going. Follow what I say. Raja Pratap Ruddho, he wanted to do this seva, and Mahaprabhu was instant very happy to see that the king is going to clean the road. Mahaprabhu was very happy, instant Mahaprabhu was so happy was that he wanted to give kippa immediately. Follow. Mahaprabhu watching, it is written that Raja Pratap Ruddho going to clean the road by boon. And by watching this seva of king, Mahaprabhu was very happy, very happy. That's why as a result, when Raja Pataprudho wanted to get the lotus feet of Mahaprabhu, which is quite impossible. Even Brahma, Sankar, who can get? No, impossible. But Raja Pataprudho wanted to get the lotus feet of Mahaprabhu. How dare Raja wanted to take the lotus feet of Mahaprabhu? But anyway, he is going to get power from devotees, great devotees like Sarvam Vatajajo or other devotees, Kasimis. No, you go, but you will have to go very carefully. How? You will have to go approach very carefully. Don't take the dress of king. You throw away and you get very humble dress. Very, very humble dress. And after that, you can sing the glories of Gopika, you know, there, Gopi Gita. Tavagatamritam tapta jivanam kaviviritam kalmasapaham savanamangalam simadatatam bhuviginantite bhuridayana. With this Gopi Gita, you can go on reciting. And you can go, Mahaprabhu, after pulling rod, feeling tired, going to take rest, taking and fresh water, fresh air there, and in the garden, Jagannath Bala, then Mahaprabhu cannot take any information. Mahaprabhu taking rest, tired. Now you can go very careful. I can go? Yes. All devotees, they are blessing. No, you can come out successful. Vaishnavir, Ashirvad, all the blessings of Guru Vaishnava, don't try to criticize. If you criticize pure Guru Vaishnava, Guru Varga, you can never come out successful. Never. All zero. Try to glorify. By the mercy of Guru Vaishnava, I can come out successful all the time. I always think about my Guru Varga. Oh, Sridhar Goswami Maharaj, Madhav Goswami Maharaj, Bhanu Goswami Maharaj, Goswami Maharaj, whole day and night I'm crying. Whole day and night I'm crying them. Whereas you are going to criticize them. They are useless. Yes. They are dedicated soul unto the lotus feet of Prabhupada. That's why they are useless. You are useful. Very good. Very good, nice Siddhanta. Whole life they have given for Prabhupada. Okay. Now point is that king now going to, collect power from Guru Vaishnava, Kripa, and gradually approaching very fearfully and singing this Gopi Gita from Bhagavatam and going to massage the leg of Mahaprabhu very, 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 with tender hand, very, very carefully, tender hand, very soft hand, going to massage the leg of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and singing. Immediately Mahaprabhu with closing eyes, taking fresh air under the tree in Jagannath Ballabh Udvan garden. Then Mahaprabhu without information, knowing everything, what Mahaprabhu cannot know. Mahaprabhu can know everything. But externally, without information, going to give embrace to the king and speaking, who is you going to give me nectar? Achimbidasi. Suddenly you are coming to give me nectar. You are going to give nectar to me. I have nothing to give because I am beggar. I am sannyasis. More kichu dite nahi dilu alingon. I am going to embrace you. Who are you? You are going to give me nectar. I have nothing to give. I am going to give only embrace. More kichu dite nahi dilu alingon. I am going to give you embrace. Get satisfied. What to do? Mahaprabhu is going to give embrace, you see, which is impossible. To get the embrace of Bhagavan, oh my God, impossible. He's going to get. What is not possible? What is not possible by the kripa of Guru Vaishnava? Everything is possible. What not possible? Everything possible. So they are speaking. more kichu dita nahi dirwanu. So I am going to speak this very important point. Very important point. We have seen in the life of Bhaktivalabha Tirtha Maharaj, my Guru Pad Padma, Vaman Goswami Maharaj, all follow. They are always ready to do any seva. Tirtha Goswami Maharaj going to clean all utensils. Cooking done, cooking already done, bhoga already offered, but noontime nobody going to clean. Then Tirtha Maharaj coming out and started cleaning that bartan, my utensil. All people coming, oh Maharaj, you are doing, but what I can do? You cannot allow me to do this seva? This is not seva? Nice seva? Follow what I say. Every seva. Then common people also can get inspiration. Common devotees, they can also get inspiration. Whereas he is doing, so he must do. So Bhagavan also going to show the mood. Bhagavan going to take the water wash of Brahman in Gayadham. Eh? To get cure of the fever. You can remember. So it is a usual, you know, tendency of Bhagavan. Bhagavan always going to glorify Guru Vaishnava. And those are bonded souls, they want to criticize Guru Vaishnava. They cannot glorify. He cannot sow. How you can understand who is pure Vaishnava? How you can understand he is a nice Vaishnava? How you can understand he is an international, a nice preacher? How are you going to understand? My Guru Padma one day speaking to me. I was in Puri. Guru Maharaj also was in Puri. Guru Maharaj speaking, hey, go quickly. Go quickly to Chaitanya Gauriya Math. I mean, why? I know that is the appearance day of Madhava Goswami. I was supposed to go. Guru said, hey, quickly go to Chaitanya Gauriya Math, Puri. Maharaj, you can go after. No, now you go. Harikata, Harikata, you can hear. All the glories of Madhava Goswami Maharaj. I cannot go. I am sick here. I am lying here sick. And also Guru Maharaj giving me instruction. You are going to the temple to take prasadam, hearing Harikatha, you are lucky. One point is, you know that, don't forget. I heard the second part of his life history, Jivani. Already published. You'll have to collect it for me. I like to read. Come on! He is a junior godbrother of Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Maharaj. He is a junior godbrother of Guru Maharaj. Guru Padmatma, not one instant. I can give so many examples. Not one example. So humble Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Maharaj. Even in dream we cannot imagine. You can bring the second part of the life history of Madhava Goswami Maharaj. I like to read it. You must bring it. Eh? You can ask. You can pay them. You see how humble. If I speak the name of Guru Maharaj, I need to pay them? No, you can pay them. Huh? One time, so many examples I can give you. One day Guru Maharaj went to Bhakti Mayuk Bhagavad Goswami Maharaj. Follow. Near Bharampur, not from Ekchakradham you can go. Ekchakradham, you can go through that place, but not actually Ekchakra. From there, Ekchakra is 18 kilometers. There also, there I've been there. Very nice elevated sadhu. Bhakti Mayuk Bhagavad Goswami Maharaj. Guru Maharaj came earlier. Kesava Goswami Maharaj, Guru Maharaj, they came, you know, before. And that Maharaj came after. But still, Maharaj going to take darshan. Follow, Bolpur. It is near Bolpur. It is near Bolpur, not near Bolpur, it is near Bolpur. Maharaj going there taking travel, went to take the darshan of Bhakti Mayuk Bhagavad Goswami Maharaj. Somehow, the situation was that, situation was that he was very sick and for some reason, I don't like to discuss, he couldn't take darshan of Bhakti Mayuk Bhagavad Goswami Maharaj. One Nitai Prabhu, why he is a Grihastha disciple of Gauranga Prabhu. I've been there, Harikatha in Bolpur, with Chaitanya Gauriya Math. Gauranga Babu is the disciple of Parpalanda Madhu Goswami Maharaj. He is speaking to me that your Guru Maharaj come back to Bolpur. Preaching party was then Bolpur. Maharaj went to take darshan of take darshan of his godbrother, Bhaktimai Bhagavan Goswami Maharaj. Somehow, for some special reason, darshan was not possible. Maharaj come back. Gauranga Mahaprabhu speaking, he is crying like a child, weeping. Weeping, just like a child is weeping. Gauranga Mahaprabhu was very afraid of the fact. Hey Maharaj, what happens? What happens to who speak? What to you? Maharaj, what happens? Why you are crying like a child? We can die. You are crying. Then Maharaj weeping and speaking. Today, I could not take darshan of Vaishnav. My life is useless. My life useless. I could not take darshan. I went there. I could not get the darshan of Vaishnav. Oh my God. I cannot take water. I cannot drink water. I cannot take prasadam. I was just down to hear. That time I was not there. Long before. Even that time I didn't take diksha from Guru Maharaj. Long before. I was stunned to hear the prakita humble attitude. So many cases I can speak. One day, with all preaching party, I want to establish this point, what Sanatana Gosai wanted to establish. Same thing I'm speaking. Not out of, our discussion. Try to understand. Parampujya Sridhar Goswami Maharaj, exalted devotee, great parshad of Prabhupada, he was expressing Sikh Leela. But Guru Maharaj was outside with preaching party. Our Chaitanya Guru Maharaj in charge of Mayapur branch, Naran Maharaj speaking. So we drop in Navadvip station. From there, we took one car to come to Mayapur, but your Guru Maharaj, Atat Srila Bhakti Purna Puri Goswami, crying and speaking. Naran Maharaj was that time took sannyas or not, I cannot remember. But anyway, what happened? Naran Maharaj speaking, your Gurudev repeatedly requesting us to drop. He liked to drop there in Gauranga Setu. From there, he can go to Chaitanya Saraswat Math very quickly. Gauranga Setu, one bridge over Gauranga, over Ganga. Gauranga Setu. Maharaj, you drop me here. Maharaj, you go, you are coming from pitching party, long distance, you are tired. No. No, you drop me here. My heart is crying. I think Sridhar Maharaj can go away leaving us. You drop me here. No. Forcefully, Guru Maharaj dropped there. Old man. With all luggage going to Chaitanya Saraswat Math, really discover Sridhar Maharaj is sick. Very sick. Maharaj going to the bhajan kutir of Sridhar Goswami. Sridhar Maharaj saying, he is very sick, lying in bed. He cannot pay dandavat to my Guru Maharaj. My Guru Maharaj paying dandavat to Sridhar Goswami and crying like a child. Sridhar Maharaj, you can go away leaving us. How we can leave? Don't go away leaving us. And Guru Maharaj took decision to leave. Guru Maharaj took decision to stay there for a long time, so long as Maharaj manifesting Sikh Leela. Follow what I say. This is called Godbrother. This is called idealism of Godbrother. This is called the exact idealism of Godbrother. My Guru Maharaj is senior to Sridhar Goswami Maharaj. He came much before. But still, this come before or late is not a question. They are all eternal Parsada Prabhupada. So I cannot speak that way. Madhav Goswami is late. Sridhar Goswami Maharaj came late. I never like to speak that. I always pay dandavat to them, always crying to get their kipa. This is called the idealism of Godfather, jumping into fire to save Godfather. So loveful affair. Directly I have seen Satya Govind. How many case I can speak? How many case I can speak about Bhakti Pumak Purigasi Maha so that you can believe me? I don't know when you can believe me. I don't know when you can believe me 100%. I don't know, you cannot believe me. Practically I have seen Satya Govinda Maharaj, who is the disciple of Prabhupada. He was Brahmachari. He was helping in publication, seva, binding, this, so many things. Later on, he took, after Prabhupada gone, he was staying in Chaitanya Math, sometime Jogopit, sometime. When my Guru Maharaj was almost 97, 95, 96, that time, he was in Jogopit Simandir. Now one day, he used to love me very much. I got the scope to serve him, you know, in old age. I'm very happy, very lucky, I think. Great Vaishnava, but cannot speak Harikatha properly. That's great Vaishnava. He's a great Vaishnava. His feeling is great. He cannot speak Harikatha properly. This one kind of Leela. You speak Harikatha, I can. No, Maharaj, you are here, you speak. Many incidents I don't like to speak. It will take long time. Now one day, Maharaj in the morning time, 5 o'clock, winter season, morning time, coming in a mop to pay dandavat to my Guru Maharaj, because he is junior godfather. Paying dandavat, my Guru Maharaj was stunned. Oh my godfather, why, how you are in the morning, so early in the morning, coming here? Huh? Why? In the old age, you should come later, you know, winter season. Maharaj, then Satya Govinda Maharaj, out of fear, speaking in front of Guru Maharaj. Out of so many, I got the scope to hear so many things from him. He's speaking in front of my Guru Maharaj. Maharaj, today Radharani coming in my dream and speaking very heavily. Hey, why you are not taking sannyasi? Puri Maharaj is there. You go take sannyasi from there. I was afraid. Radharani coming and chiding me. Hey, why you are not taking sannyas? Puri Maharaj is, go and take sannyas. So I am coming in front of you. You can give me sannyasi or not, I don't know. Maharaj laughing and laughing. What do you say, my godfather? I can give sannyas to you? Eh? How it is possible? Eh? Okay, you come. Guru Maharaj giving sannyas to him. Many times, he was speaking so many secret things in front of me. He is saying, night time I was doing that Satya Govinda Maharaj speaking to me. His direct feeling. He is speaking, I was doing Harinam, my son. I was doing Harinam in Jogpitsa Mandir. I was doing Harinam here and there. I was, you know, doing Harinam very nicely. But I heard the news of Gaurang Mahaprabhu's, you know, leg ring, pile, chum, the sound of Gaurang Mahaprabhu. Really? Yes, I heard it. Oh, so nice, so sweet sound, you know, I cannot describe my song. This way, all great the Nanananda Babaji Maharaj, all great devotees, Santu Goswami Maharaj, Bhakti Vallabhtirtha Bharati Maharaj, all they are blessing me. So I have no nothing, all their property. Follow what I say. So this way, the humble attitude I was speaking about. This way I was explaining this, how humble those Guru Vaishnava. I have never seen in the whole life, Guru Maharaj never criticized anybody. Whole life. Be senior godfather, junior godfather, it matters a little. Never. What to speak about senior, junior godbrother, even disciple, they are in the category of disciple. They never criticize. Never criticize. Never speak anything. Always humble attitude. Those who have seen the lotus feet of Bhakti Pramod Puri Krishna, they can describe in front of you. How humble. I have never seen in my life so humble attitude. So Guru Maharaj used to speak. Guru Maharaj wanted to teach me the humbleness is the first and foremost thing, very important thing. Dinede odik daya karen Bhagavan. Maharaj, Guru Maharaj used to speak, those who are very humble, they are thinking themselves helpless, helpless, useless. For them, Gaurang Mapu thinking to bestow kipa. Those who are popped up, I have done preaching, I have done so thing. You know, for them, kipa is not possible. Humble attitude is the basic thing to get kipa. External name, fame, position is, it is not so big thing. Follow. Here, actually, so I was discussing this point, you know, that sa cha agarvaha sada nicha jaggo sevabhi rachutam bhaja mano akhilano lokano ramayaswa chuta priyaha. That king is great king, but still always he is going to do seva of sama, like a humble man, very, very low, like cleaning the place, you know. I also, it was my seva to clean the prasadam place, latrine, this, that I used to do. You know, sar prasadam, follow what I say. This way, we are habituated to see all the acharan of Bharti Maharaj, all Siddha Goswami, you know, but Bhakti Pama Guru Maharaj, all Santa Goswami Maharaj, we have habituated to see. Follow. This way, Bhajamana Akhilana Lokana Ramayaswa Achyutaha is going to give full satisfaction to Achyuta by this kind of very humble seva. So, cha agaravaha sada nicha jaggo sevabhi rachutam bhajamana khilana lokano ramachi achyutaha. Achyuta priya raja, there is no humble, there is no false ego inside, always doing seva like a very, very small man, very insignificant seva is doing. Achyuta rachana is going to serve Krishna. We think archan means we are going to offer flower to Krishna. But Rantidev not going to offer flower. Rantidev going to serve all poor men with the mood that inside them Bhagavan is there, so I am serving them. Rantidev wanted to give everything to all poor and disabled, for to them with a mood to serve Bhagavan. The mood of Rantidev was that if I am serving poor man or disabled, I am serving Krishna. Krishna is everywhere. He wanted to make a link with Krishna. But Jarabharat, Bharatji Maharaj was bound to come in the form of Jarabharat. Bharatji Maharaj was very nice devotee. His bhajan was Gyanamishra Bhakti. Whereas the bhajan procedure of this Rantidev is Karmamishra Bhakti. Try to understand, I can come to this point. Many times before I discussed, you know, Raya Ramananda Sangh was there also. Karmamishra Bhakti, Gyanamishra Bhakti. The bhajan procedure of Bharatji Maharaj was much far, far better than the procedure of Karmamishra Bhakti. But Bharatji Maharaj was not successful, but Rantidev was successful. Why? Bharatji Maharaj was not successful because he wanted to serve the deer without any link with Bhagavan. Try to understand. Follow. Why there was bondage for Bharatji Maharaj? It was not proper on his part to serve the deer baby with full heart. His attention was diverted to the deer baby from the lotus feet of Supreme Lord. If he could make one relationship, he was successful to deliver the baby from the water. It is not bad. Bharatji Maharaj was not, Bharatji Maharaj was successful to deliver the baby deer from the current of water. That was not bad. After that, what he was doing, it was not good. It was one kind of trap. The baby deers, he was going to give full attention and affection to the deer baby. That was danger. If he could take the deer baby and go to the forest and give the deer baby in among the deer, all other deer gang, flock of deer, he could allow that baby to go there. Mother die, okay. He is going to take trouble like mother and father, take her. After that, this become a bondage. His attention is totally diverted. His attention was totally diverted from the lotus feet of Supreme Lord. That was a big problem. So he was bound to take birth in the form of a deer baby. It is Gita, it is written, Jang Jang Baopi Saranam Bhavam, Jang Jang Baopi Saranam Bhavam, Tajatyante Klevaram. This sloka you can find from Gita. Whatever you are thinking at the time of death, you will have to take birth accordingly. So it's a great mistake. After that, Bharatji Maharaj went took birth in the form of deer baby is crying. I was Bharatji Maharaj, now I am bound to take the birth of the, oh my God. Then after that, he was going to leave the body in the water current of Gandaki Nadi, very pure Nadi, very, 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 you know, then going to leave the body with the thinking of Bhagavan, and after that, going to take birth at Jaravarat. So he took decision not to speak anymore. He wanted to exhibit himself as dumb and deaf. That was his resolution. I lose my life! So no more I can make mistake, no. So Bharatji Maharaj could not link the seva of the dear baby with Bhagavan. That was the main. But Ranthidev was 100% successful. Anybody coming in front of him is giving water, everything, water, whatever he has. By always singing, I am serving Supreme Lord. Supreme Lord is there inside the heart of everybody in the form of Paramatma. He was successful. Karma Mishra Bhakti, he was successful in this way of Karma Mishra Bhajan. That was the main. Now, here it is written that the king of South India is going to serve Bhagavan very humble way. Even this kind of very low seva is going to do. Tashyagre vividhoir nama gatha kirtanair swayam. What written? Try to hear properly. Tashyagre vividhoir nama gatha kirtanair swayam nitvana divyani gitani gayan baddani badayan. He himself, going to sing the glories of Bhagavan and dancing Tasyagre Bibidhoir Namagatha by calling Hey Janardhan, Hey Rishikesh, Hey Madhusudan, Tasyagre Bibidhoir Namagatha Sankirtanai Swayam by the help of Sankirtan and dancing Kitan Nityana Dibyani, very very Dibba Nitya Gitani Gayan, singing song and playing music. Kartal and then playing on Kartal or Midanga, Badayam, Bhatri, Bharja, Sutai, Potrair, Bhritvam, Apatta, Purahitai, Annaischa, Sajjanai, Swakam, Prabhum, Tvam, Tosayam, Sada. Together with wife, brother, son, daughter, friends, Brahman, all Purahit, those who are priests, all together, grandson, all together, they are making a very nice music and dancing and singing, bhatri bharya sutvai potrair dhritvam apatto purahitvai annescha sajjvanai svakam prabhum tvam tosayat sada. He used to give full satisfaction to the Supreme Lord. He wanted to satisfy the Supreme Lord from heart. There is no artificiality, wanted to do something concrete. Tete tasso guna brataha krishna vrtvanuvartinaha sankhyatum kuti kathante gayante kuti vamaya. How much I can speak? How I can speak? How much I know? Even how much I know? How much I can sing his glories? And how much I know? Tete tasso guna brataha krishna bhaktyanuvartinaha. His Krishna Bhakti, his Swayam Krishna Bhakti, this kind of, I cannot explain. Even I don't know. I have no account. Tete tasso guna brataha krishna bhakti anuvartinaha. Tete tasso guna brataha krishna bhakti anuvartinaha. Sankhatum koti kathante gayante kotiba maya. How much I know, so that I can sing. I cannot limit it. I am going to speak something in front of you. You yourself can take trouble to go there and check up. I am speaking lie or right. You go yourself and check up. Here you see, you can yourself take trouble to go there and check up. You are going to glorify me. It is, is not, proper. You cannot glorify me. If you go there and check up the activities of that king, then you can understand why I was speaking. I have done nothing. I am a very poor Brahman. I have no appliance, nothing. What kind of donation I can give? What kind of prasadam I can arrange for? I have done something, but nothing yet. Follow what I say. Krishna is Krishna Bhakti Anuvartini. Krishna Bhaktir Anuvarti. Try to understand. Sanatan Goswami is not going to speak that Krishna, he is a great Krishna Bhakta. But speaking Krishna Bhakti Anuvartini. In the way of Krishna Bhakti. Krishna Bhaktir Anuvarti. Follow. Krishna Bhakti Anukul. Anukul doesn't mean full Bhakti. Anukul, okay, but it depends upon how much anukul, how far, Bhakti anukula matro, bhakti anukula matro karjaro sikar, bhakti pratikula kaj barjo dinka. Sanatan, actually our Bhakti Vinod Thakur, follow. Bhakti anukul matro karjaro sikar, bhakti pratikula karjo barjo angikar. Bhakti anukul man favorable activities of bhakti. So I have to. So you see, now you understand. Now you understand how humble Guru Vaishnava is. Those who are even going to get the smell. Those who are even going to get the smell of Krishna Bhakti. How much humble attitude they are. You can go mad. You have no conception, no idea about pure bhakti. You have no information about the heart of Bhakti Bhavatpuyaki Srimahasiddhar. No! Because you are not going to their level. Nobody going to glorify them properly. Nobody going to glorify. How long? All over the world, all the name of our Guru Vaishnava, all our great Guru Vargas, nobody knows the name. Because their name were kept concealed. Not preached purposely. So you see, Parikshit Maharaj now going to this. You should remember, don't try to break your link. If you break your link, you cannot understand. Try to understand. Parikshit Maharaj going to speak this Brihad Bhagavatamrita in front of his mother Uttara. And in the meantime, in this description, in this Harikatha, this kind of topics are coming. Follow what I say. And Janmajaya hearing. Try to understand. If you break the link, you cannot understand. Parikshit Maharaj was speaking this Harikatha to Mother Uttara. Now these topics, Vaishyapam Rishi, no, Jaimini Rishi, this topic speaking to Janmajoy, Vyad Bhagavatam, how did it happen, this, that, follow. So actual, this Vyad Bhagavatam is spoken by Parikshit Maharaj speaking, and that topics actually Janmajoy, the son of hearing now. Now Parikshit Maharaj not going to explain the point. The tato nipavaram drashtum taddeshe narada vrajan deva pujats sabha shaktyas tatro tatraikhyata prajaha. Tato nipavara, he great king. Parikshit vaja tato nipavara drashtum. Sorry, you try to understand this point. Parikshit Maharaj, the great king speaking, that tato nipavara drashtum. Nipavara means, here nipavara is title is used for the Dakshin South Indian king. Parikshit Maharaj using this title, Parikshit Maharaj using this title for that great South Indian king. So Parikshit Maharaj vacha tato, after hearing all this explanation from that Dija, tato nipavaram, tato after that, nipavaram dashtum, to watch the king, to watch the king, taddeshe narada brajan. Narad wanted to go to that place immediately, because Naradji can fly and go. Naradji all over the universe can fly anywhere, only can wish and go, and play on the guitar, you know. Eh? Piano is playing all the time, Narada. Then Naradji Maharaj actually playing on, you know, musical instrument and all. And our Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing very nice, kirtan. Narada Muni Bajaye Bina Radhika Ramano Name. Very nice kirtan, Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing. Naradji always playing a musical instrument and going. Mano, tato nipavaram dashtum, to see the king, taddeshe narada brajan. Narada wanted to go to that place, that kingdom. Deva pujat sava shaktas tatro tatrikhata bhajaha. After entering the country, deva pujat sava, deva pujat sava shaktas tatro tatrikhata bhajaha. There he is watching rightly, okay. All the countrymen, they are busy with, you know, Deva Puja. They are always busy with, you know, arranging festival of Krishna. Oh, really? Deva Puja Sabha Sakta. Asakta mane? They are in a very attraction they have inside their heart. Naradji Maharaj watching, really so? Hey, Naradji Maharaj watching all different kind of, you know, countrymen, they are all really, they are busy with full, you know, different kind of Deva Puja, Utsav. They are very easy, very nice. After that, I can explain tomorrow about what happening, what our Sanatana Gosvami Pada wanted to establish by this. But before understanding, you must realize the sloka I started with. And also one South Indian king, very, very humble. So humble, so humble, I cannot explain. Kulasekhar king, very, very nice devotee. He is crying and speaking in front of Bhagavan. It is the success of my life, Bhagavan. Oh God, it is the success of my life. If you can, it is my prayer to you and to your lotus feet repeatedly. I like to become servant of the 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 servant. Follow what I say. Majjanmana phalamidam madukaitavari madpartaniya madanograhayeva. तत् भृत्त भित्त परिचारक भित्त भित्त भृत्तस्य भित्त इति मां स्मरो लोकनाथ। फॉलो पर से यू विल हैव टू अप्लाई, वी विल हैव टू अप्लाई इन आवर लाइफ। मज्जन्म न फलमिदं मधुकैट भारे, इट इज द अल्टीमेट रिजल्ट आई कैन थिंक, गुड रिजल्ट इन माई लाइफ। इट इज माई प्रेयर ऑन टू योर लोटस फीट ओनली दैट आई कैन बिकम द सर्वेंट ऑफ द सर्वेंट ऑफ द सर्वेंट ऑफ द सर्वेंट ऑफ सर्वेंट ऑफ गुरु वैष्णव। बट आई वॉन्ट टू बिकम द मैस्टर ऑफ गुरु वैष्णव। आई कैन स्पीक ऑल रविश अगेन गुरु वैष्णव। दिस इज माई पुअर कंडीशन स्टेटस, फॉलन कंडीशन। मज्जन्म न फलमिदं मधुकैट भारे, मत्प्रार्थनीय मदनुग्रह एष एव। तद्भृत्त भित्तो परिचारिक भित्त भित्तो भित्तस्य भित्तो इति मां स्मरो लोकनाथः। पांच कल्प दुर्वस्य के पास सिंधु पतितानं पावने भो वैष्णवभ्यो नमः।